Hi, my name is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. It's a beautiful day in Oregon, and I tell you what, if you like things to be green and you like lots of water and recreation, Oregon's the place you need to go. And when you do, come see us at the RV Corral, because we've got a lot of RVs here to show you. This is one I took in on trade recently. It's an older 1990 Hitchhiker Champagne Edition. It's a 31-foot. And it's a 31-foot with a slide. And you normally don't see them this old, but it's an optional slide in that year that you could put into it. And it's got a lot of room on the inside. It's a great unit if somebody wants something inexpensive to either live in or to even recreate and have something large enough and affordable, because we've got this price to sell. Again, 31 feet, got a solid fiberglass front cap. It's a fifth wheel edition, of course. Champagne, and got lots of storage in it. Got a front storage compartment up front, LPG storage right there. You get 2 7.5 gallon propane tanks. The customer that owned this had a security system put in for him where the door trips an alarm when it goes off. For security reasons, he had it installed. It's got a large awning on the outside, and it's just got a lot of storage for an older unit. The tires are in decent shape. It has what they call a corrugated sidewall. That was kind of how they built these back then. It was a fiberglass. And it's got a solid rear cap as well. And if you know anything about Hitchhiker, you know that Hitchhiker built a great unit. They were made to withstand the cold temperatures and heat, well air conditioned, well heated. And this is just a good unit. The customer prior that traded this in took the time to make sure the roof was well sealed and all of the seams were taped down, and so there was no leakage at all. And I can't find any leaks on the inside. He took very good care of it. But let's go take a look at the inside of this fifth wheel. When you come into the inside, you got a 6 cubic foot fridge and a freezer. All the cabinets here are solid finished wood. So, and that's one thing nice about these guys back then, is they did a terrific job building cabinetry in these. They were not a cheap unit. And they used etched glass in all the doors. This is a nice little kitchen area right here that has some real nice storage for dishes and whatever it may be that you want to keep in the kitchen area. And then you got lots of storage here also in the right by the sink, and lots of countertop space. This unit weighs 8,565 pounds dry. So 3/4 ton needs to tow this. Could be a gas or a diesel, either one. Has a large oven and 4-burner stove, which is common for this year. But just the countertop, you know, the people that owned it took really good care of it. And, you know, they recovered all of the vinyl top work, and they just did a real nice job. It's been well taken care of. It was their home for a few years, and they took care of anything when it started to go bad. They would take care of it. They wouldn't leave it. If they noticed that it did leak anywhere, they were right on it. Now, here's the slide out. This slide out right here is, you can put a couple of swivel rockers. Right now, it just has one in there, but you can put a couple of swivel rockers or recliners in here. And this is just kind of like the rear living area. So you have the window in the back. You have all day and night shades. There's your day shade. Here's your night shade. Comes with a cassette stereo system. Fantastic fan right here. Here's your air conditioning unit right above the head here. We have an air conditioning unit. That actually, now back in 1990, this is kind of how they did it. It discharged the air and it went through this direction tube right up here, all the way up into the bedroom, and blew cold air up in here as well as down here. So in each spot, they had these vents that opened up in each section. It's kind of nice because it dumped some cold air right here in the kitchen area if you needed to. All of your fluid levels and everything are right here above the oven, so you can check your black, your gray, your fresh water, battery condition. Plus, it has a fan and a hood light as well. But one thing I want to point out in here is all of the windows. This whole area right here has lots of windows, and you're not going to feel confined in here. It's just, it's easy to see out. And just for an older fifth wheel, this is something you need to come look at. As we go up into the bathroom area, typical to hitchhikers is a storage compartment right here that you can get down into the bottom of it. And there's lots of storage right here in the bathroom area. As you come up into here, there's a place to hang clothes right there. Also got a nice big sink with a medicine cabinet. A water heater switch right here. So this is what they've done is they've switched this water heater to gas electric. It's a 6-gallon gas electric hot water heater. And as you look into the bathroom, I'll have Curtis come in here and we'll open that up. Got a nice large bathroom area with another medicine cabinet above the toilet. And one thing I like about this for an older fifth wheel is you can walk up in here. You know, some of these older fifth wheels, you got to kind of stoop down and to get up in here, but you can walk underneath this one. Now you have another large storage closet right here as well. So you can hang clothes here, put shoes up here. Right, I'm about 5 foot, 10 and a half, almost 11, and I can stand up in here. Place for a TV right here, and another big window right here at the foot of the bed. This is a nice little fifth wheel. If you want something inexpensive that does the job, you know, you could live in this or you could take it camping with you, whatever you want. Come see Joe Bass at the RV Corral. I'd love to help you buy this thing and get it hooked onto your truck for you. And I'd love to meet you. Joe Bass with the RV Corral, call me and I'll take good care of you. Thank you.